Carlos Marin. Ia yang tertua, solis bariton asal Spanyol, mengambil kelas vokal masterclass, penyanyi opera. Les Miserables, The Man of Lancia, Beauty and the Beast. Dijuluki Primo Baritono di tiap pertunjukannya.
And we're very happy to be here, and hopefully the audience is going to love it.
David Miller, termuda, tenor asal negeri Paman Sam, lulusan Conservatory Ohio, lanjut Bachelor Art, Vocal Performance, dan Master Jurusan Teater Opera. Pernah manggung di Broadway sebagai Rudolfo dalam opera La Bohème.
Well, hello to Jakarta. We're very happy to be here. It's our first time, and we're very excited.
Sebastian Izambak, 33 tahun, 7 Maret nanti. Karakter suara pop, berlatih secara otodidak. Sebelum bergabung, ia penyanyi sekaligus penulis lagu dan produser handal di Perancis.
Hello Jakarta, we're very pleased to be here, even though we just arrived and...
Urs Buhler, solis tenor asal Swiss. Menjelang 36 tahun. Awalnya anak band beraliran hard rock, banting setir kemudian ke sekolah vokal di Academy for School and Church Music di Luzern, Swiss. Lanjut studi di Conservatory yang ada di Amsterdam. Adalah Simon Cowell, sang juri American Idol, yang jeli membaca pasar dan mempertemukan keempatnya. Kekuatan kuartet ini terletak pada ramuan pop berbalut opera, baik lirik dan juga musik. Meski dibentuk secara instan, asam garam masing-masing personil membuat mereka bukan kelompok vokal aji mumpung.
Halo, selamat pagi saudara. Il Divo berkonser di Indonesia. Empat pria yang berasal dari empat negara yang berbeda dan memiliki kualitas suara yang prima ini akan menghibur para penggemarnya dalam sebuah konser berdurasi 100 menit dengan 18 lagu. Seperti apa keceriaan konser nantinya, saya ajak Anda untuk ikuti terus dalam Dialog Pagi, Liputan 6 Pagi, akhir pekan bersama saya, Muhammad Akhir.
Excited about the show and stuff. Como esta?
Absolutely, estamos muy bien. Yeah. We're excited because we were waiting for a really long time to come over here. And well, hopefully the people can love it.
Cool. And you know, you guys obviously came from different backgrounds, from the places and stuff. Do you guys experience any obstacles in forming the group, at the beginning?
Oh yeah, of course. There's always obstacles. We met each other 2 days before we went into the studio, which is not so odd for the opera world, but for the pop world, that's fairly strange.
So, speaking about your music, you guys have, moved, like you said, 3 years. Are you guys feeling satisfied artistically of what you've achieved so far?
That's a very good question. I think that is one particular thing about us. We're very perfectionist. We're never really completely happy with what we've achieved and what we've done. Be that a concert, we always conversate and think more like, oh, that wasn't good, or that went wrong, or that was not just perfect, than coming off stage and say, oh, I sound great, tonight. That's not the way you come off stage, Because as a musician, you are never there. You have never arrived. There's always ways to grow and to develop. And that's the same with the repertoire on our albums. Tempo, we finally managed to include a bit more up-tempo than only just those ballads. And we'll see probably on the next album if we can pull that a bit further in a direction, or maybe do something completely different as, for example, the collaboration with another artist that is in a completely different genre, like a rapper or somebody.
Going back to you again, Sebastian, I heard from some friends who attended your show in Singapore that you missed a part. What happened? How did you tackle that? You must be nervous or ashamed or something. Tell me.
Actually, not only one part. I wish it was only one part. What happened exactly is that was the second show, and sometimes you feel very confident on the second show, thinking, yeah, you've got the show, and maybe you're probably more flexible and relaxed, so you lose a bit of concentration. And what happened is I just missed a bar in the intro. I get confused with the song, and I just forget the words. I was next door, so I said, I forgot the lyrics. I was like lost, and then all of a sudden on the second song, because I just, I did, the first song absolutely wrong, then the second song I was just mixed up, I was unconcentrated at all, I lost the plot.
Yeah,
well, I don't get very often nervous, I have to say, I'm very lucky about that, but for them, that day I was like, freaking out. I love the show.
But seriously, tell me, what kind of a crowd is it good, you know, do you expect to be tonight in Indonesia, in Jakarta?
Well, we've been told that the Indonesian public is that they're absolutely crazy for us here, which is very exciting since we've never been here before. And I don't know. I don't even know what to be looking forward to. I'm hoping they're going to enjoy it, and if they enjoy it, that they're just as vocal as they possibly can. Because the more we can get them to enjoy themselves, and the more that they can give back to us, and it just gives us more, and you know, it all keeps building on itself. So I think it's going to be really good.
Do you have any special, you know, steps or what to do to work with the Asian crowds, for example? Obviously, we have distinct type of crowd, different from, you know, the Americans and the Europeans. Do you have any special tips that you guys have received so far?
Tips that we received?
Yeah, I mean, do you know, like, what to do, how to work with the Asian crowds? You know, we obviously...
The thing is, you never know it, because we just came from South Asia, I mean, from Japan and China. Mm-hmm. It was really funny because they were really, really polite, really clapping, very, very polite people. Then suddenly, at one point, that we are sitting in the front, in the edge of the stage, everyone just run to us and they just rape us everywhere. and when I say everywhere, it's everywhere.
All right.
Sebastian, rape. And they were really like suddenly really, really aggressive and like, wow, you were holding really back. So yeah.
But how do you take that? I mean, do you take it as a compliment or?
Oh, you take when you grab you, you scream when you grab.
Maybe it had a very good story when you were in Japan, huh?
Oh yeah, we were in Japan and this like you said, they were quiet, and then we sit on the edge of the stage and then they all start really pressing in, and there was a woman who had my knee, was pressing into her chest, and she was just being squashed by the people behind her into my leg. And I was looking down because I could feel a lot of pressure here, and I was thinking, I can't be comfortable. So I looked down to see if she's okay, and she looks up to me and she goes, I love you.
Harapan publik Indonesia terpenuhi. Mereka terpuaskan dengan konser Il Divo. Tak percuma, para Il Divo mania baris mengantri dan mesti merogoh kocek dalam-dalam untuk membeli tiket yang terbilang tak murah. Saat konser, telinga para penikmat musik dimanjakan dengan tembang-tembang yang umumnya merupakan repertoar musik pop romantis legendaris dibalut dengan gaya opera. Cita rasa ini sangat terasa, kala keempatnya berkolaborasi seperti saat mendendangkan tembang Situ Mehamis. Komentar penonton beragam, namun secara keseluruhan mereka mengaku bisa menikmati konser dari awal hingga akhir.
Sudah ternyata Il Divo membawakan serangkaian lagu pop dalam balutan musik klasik dalam penampilannya. Rata-rata dalam bahasa Italia ataupun Spanyol. Kira-kira penonton ngerti nggak ya? Dan mereka kira-kira puas ya dengan konser yang baru saja berlangsung tadi? Kita tanya mereka.
Suaranya bagus, tapi pasti memerlukan mikrofon ya.
Kenapa?
Bukan bintang opera. Kalau bintang opera nggak pakai loudspeaker.
Suaranya, penampilannya, terus mereka berempat kayaknya cocok banget berempat.
Bagus.
No.
Ya, top apa? Lightning-nya terus suaranya itu.
Iya, dalam secara keseluruhan bagus. Baik dengan konteks dengan audiens itu sangat bagus sekali.
I like all, I must say. It was very good.
Kelompok vokal ini merajai setidaknya 26 tangga lagu di berbagai negara, 13 diantaranya duduk sebagai jawara. Il Divo masih akan melanjutkan perjalanannya ke sejumlah negara dan akan berujung di akhir Juni nanti saat mereka berkonser di kota Dublin, Irlandia.
Saudara, konser Il Divo baru saja usai dan mereka semua tampaknya harus berkemas karena konser dunia mereka masih terus berlanjut.